Lamin Jane.
I'm a senior guide of Tanje Village Museum. And this is a Tanje Village Museum, and it's a natural history and ethnographic museum. And there is divided into four main areas. The first one is the natural history gallery. And there we also have another gallery that is traditional handcraft on our traditional craft like weaving, batik, tie-dye, and leather work. And also it's an open-air museum. There we got some structures out. There under the tree we have a platform called the Bantaba. In Senegambia, a Bantaba means a meeting point where ceremonies normally take place. In those days, as we don't have a city or town hall, where the council of elders will meet and sort out things about village development and important issues or ceremonies. From there, we come to the craft on the weaving, that we weave our traditional fabric, as in the past, we don't have machine or mechanic factories. Then there we make our local hand weaving that we have different ethnics in the country. We, they use this for their various ceremonies, like christening, weddings, circumcisions, or yearly festival, or our kiptansis, their ceremony. And there we go further to that of traditional Gambian compound. That one, the idea is trying to put the whole Gambia under one roof in terms of culture and tradition. There the compound is divided into two quarters. The first one is the main quarter. The second part is that of the women quarter. Because traditionally in Senegambia, it's a tradition that men and women live separately. The reason for this one is for security, as we have different ethnics in the country. Those days, before we have one central governor, each of these ethnic have their own small states with their chief or king, and they are always been eager to conquer their neighbors in order to rule them. So for that, in our tradition, men, women don't fight, but men are there to protect the women and the kids in times of war. And the second reason is that of our traditional polygamy system in Senegambia, a system where men marry several wives. So for that, men are stationed in the first quarter and all the women will be in the other quarter as they are married to one man as a husband. And the idea of that is to bring them together in harmony and peace. So it will be meeting their husband in terms by this. And from there, we come to the fourth part. That one is the nature trail about flora and fauna, which is very much deteriorated nowadays because of human activities towards the nature. There we lose all our big five like elephant, giraffe, lion, leopard, you name them, because of human activities, cutting down trees for firewood, wood cutting, and deforestation, and also charcoal burning. As a result, most of the farmland also are forests are turned into farmland and residence, so they have no more natural habitat. As a result, most of these have been killed or flee. So now it's a concern to government try to rehabilitate this by protecting some areas as forest park, where in future then we'll import this from other African countries and have them back in their natural wild. And also we have some facilities attached to the museum. It's the museum Bantaba for drink shop or bar. Also we have a round huts that are used as a lodge for traditional camping for tourists, where they can experience village life. Natural History and Ethnographic Gallery. It explains all about our traditional food, instrument, drinks, and the stuff that we use naturally in the gallery.
So this room represents that of map of the Gambia. There we located some historical towns and the villages on the map. And there also, as Tanje is one of the major coastal fishing area in the village, then there we have pictures of different type of fish that we got, and also birds. As in Gambia, though we don't have big fives, but we still have a lot of birds, up to 500 different species. This site is on wildlife. There we got different species of animal. Among them, then we have snake. And in the Gambia, we have 40 different species of snake. And among these 40 species, four are the most deadly one. Those are green mamba, puff adder, and spitting cobra and forest cobra. It's turtle shell in Gambia now, they are endangered species. People are not allowed to kill them now. They are prohibited. So this one poster shows the flora and fauna of the Gambia. That shows this in the past we got all these animals. Now presently these are left. And in future, if proper care is not taken, you're going to left with only small red. That's why the government is very much concerned about the flora and fauna. Now we move to that of snakes. That big one is called python. It's said to be one of the biggest snake that we have in the Gambia now. All right, now those ones are birds of the Gambia and butterflies and the plants. So these are trophies that we won because we participated in national on that of that is environmental national environmental view when we came out first national. There we won this trophy. All right, so these are skin of some of the animal like honey badger, and this is bush buck, and this is Paddington and crocodile. So they are exhibit here to show the people that they should be protected. Now people are not allowed to kill them. All right, this side, this is Nile monitor lizard, and that one is monkey skin. In the Gambia we have four main types of monkeys. We have the red colobus, we have the velvet, and we also have red patas and the baboon. This room focuses on our traditional musical instrument in the Gambia. Since in the Gambia we have 8 major ethnics. One of them is Mandinka, Wolof, Fula, Jola, Sarahuli, Sere, you name them. And this instrument, that one belongs to the Manjago ethnic. They are small ethnic in the Gambia. They use it in for sending message across. And this one is balafon. Balafon is like a keyboard, but locally made by Mandinka ethnic that they use for ceremony. And this one, it says halam in wall, used by the Wolof ethnic, and this one for the Fula ethnic. And this is for the hunters. In the Gambia also, we have hunter families that normally use this string instrument. So this one is a kora, belong to Mandinka ethnic, and they use it for musical entertainment or ceremony. It got 21 string. This one is called tama in Senegambia, used by the Wolof, which resided both in Gambia and Senegal. This is called sabar. Sabar belong to Wolof ethnics, and it is played in a set. This one is called Seoruba, that belongs to Mandinka ethnic, called Seoruba. And this one is Junju, that belongs to the Sarahules ethnic. This one is called Jola drum, called Bukarabo. It's played by one man, just in shock. And this other one belong to the Fula ethnic. In Gambia they are called Fula, but on other countries they are called Fulani. This one belong to the Fula ethnic. In Gambia they are called Fula, but other countries they are called Fulani. And this belong to the is a female musical instrument. as in the Gambia, men have their musical instrument, likewise the women. So this is one belong to the men, female musical instrument called calabas and the flutes and rattles. These are eggs of birds that are protected. These also are birds of the Gambia that are protected now in the environment. This one shows the protected areas of the Gambia that are reserved for wildlife. This platform is called Bantaba in Mandinka, meaning a meeting or relaxing place, where all the ceremonies in the village normally take place, and where our council of elders in the village normally meet to sort out problems, where cults also are born, and ceremonies like christening, weddings, and festivals, always located under the tree, as tradition. This site is on weaving, as these are the material strips that we use for ceremonies, as they are locally handmade by a weaver. In the Gambia, weaving is done by men because women have their specific job that they do as domestic work. And these fabrics are used for our ceremonies like christening, wedding, festivals, and every ethnic got their ethnic patterns and colors for various ceremonies. So this is the traditional Gambian compound, and there is divided into two quarters. The first quarter is the main quarter, that is at the entrance where men settle in order to protect the women and the kids in times of war. And women are always at the backyard there so that men will be protecting them. And also like in our tradition where men marry several wives. So all the women as married to one husband will concentrate in one area. It will have their separate bed in the huts. And also we have a seed store where the food crops are kept. Always that one is located on the women's side, because women are responsible for all the domestic work. Men will work hard, produce food, and bring it for the women to cook, and later it will be shared. Men's hut is always at the entrance, and there the headman stays, because in our tradition, the eldest man will be the headman, and our leadership is on hierarchy, always on men first. And women also, the first wives is regarded as the head, but that one also have to be advising the young one, because she experienced married first, always is on hierarchy. Women hut always is the biggest hut that we do have, because it's the crowded hut, where all the women married to one man lives, with small kids and unmarried women until when they will get married, move to their husband. We are in the nature trail. This forest, the main idea of this is try to sensitize the young ones about the flora and fauna. And there, since in the Gambia we lose all our big five, like lion, elephant, giraffe, zebra, you name them. Now it's a pity that the government is very much concerned about our environment, trying to rehabilitate this environment. There they reserve some areas as forest park. So in school it's introduced as a subject. In school there, environmental studies, where they come here for their excursion. We sensitize them about flora and fauna. Unfortunately, we don't have the real life animal, but instead we build statues of animal to show them this is what we had in the Gambia before. So now we want to rehabilitate them by bringing them back. But that can only be done if we provide a natural habitat for them. So this is why we started with at the grassroots level with the kids in schools, so that in future we can bring this animal back when the forest is well kept. In the Gambia, the Smith are traditional castes, and they are very much important in our society. We rely on them for our farming tools that we use, also for our jewelries like bracelet, bangle, rings. A very important tree that we have, and it has very economic uses. Like nowadays, people rely on cashew as a cash crop, where they'll harvest it and sell out the seeds or nuts. And also it has medicinal uses, like chopping the bark of it, use it is very good for dysentery. This gallery is focused on traditional handcraft, that's weaving, tie-dye, and leather work. And these are crafts that we normally depend for our ceremonial purposes. Like the colors are for specific ceremonies, likewise the pattern for different ethnic-wise, or the ethnic we got in the Gambia.
My name is Abdullahi Bayo. I'm the proprietor of the first private museum in the Gambia called Tanje Village Museum. I used to work for the National Museum for many years, about 19 years. and I decided to take up an early retirement in 1997 to set up Tanje Village Museum. Reason for that, there was only one national museum built in the capital city, and the people who wanted to visit the museum had to walk or to travel all the way to Banjul. And when I retired, I decided to have a private museum in this part of the country so that people who are interested in museum can have easy access. Basically, that's the reason for coming to this part of the country. Tanje Village Museum is a natural history museum. And as I said, it was opened in 1997 and divided into four main areas. The first area is the natural history gallery, where we exhibit insects, birds, reptiles, Gambian food, Gambian drinks, etc. Second gallery talks about our traditional crafts, such as weaving, tie and dye, batik making, and leather work. The third part of the museum talks about Gambian way of life more than 150 years ago, where we try to exhibit local farming implements, cooking utensils, etc. And the fourth part deals with nature trail. When I say nature trail, I mean plants. We've got more than 60 different species of plants in the garden. Most of these plants are named and numbered. And we have a small guidebook called the Nature Trail Guidebook that tells you about the use of plants in traditional medicine, their food values, etc. And the museum has also got some facilities, such as a restaurant where people can come and enjoy Gambian food. We've also got a banta bar. A banta bar is a Mandinka word, meaning a resting place, a place for entertainment, a place for meeting. At the Tanje Village Museum, we have a live band called the Tanje Museum Band, where they entertain people using the kora, the drums, etc. And we also have a conference facilities where we hold conferences, workshops, etc. And that is an accommodation. We have about 10 rooms built in the traditional Gambian manner. For people who would like to experience our way of life, they could come there, spend the night, etc. Basically, these are the facilities we have in the museum. The main aim and objective of Tanje Village Museum is to put the entire Gambia under one roof in terms of culture and environment. And we also have a very strong environmental education built into this museum. As you may know, the Gambia government has introduced what we call social and environmental studies in schools. And Tanje Village Museum happened to be one of the best places where students come to learn about the culture and the environment. Basically, this is what the Tanje Village Museum is all about. And I must say, Tanje Village Museum is slightly different from the National Museum. Ours is an open-air museum. As I say, it's natural history and ethnography. Try to encourage it, because you don't want to duplicate what the museum, what the National Museum is doing. You want to do something different. And exactly, as I said, this is what the entire museum is all about.